So we're doing 20 years ago.
Roll some d20s.
Remember to record the results for posterity's sake.
Yes, yes, yes. Speaking of that. Oh, we are live. Oh, good. They all know our craziness. All they, as in us later, when we go back to this. Okay, those two I like. Running hot tonight. You're gone. Okay, we'll keep you for a little bit. Okay.
It's like, I don't know.
If he's talking about Roll 20, none of us are broadcasting to Roll 20, right?
I was, I thought. Hey, there he is, though.
Not on my screen.
I can hear you guys now.
Hello! Technical difficulties.
Yep. This is what happens when half the group, like, goes to try to work in the same apartment.
Yeah.
Travels cross-country.
Can you guys hear me?
Yep.
Yes,
yep.
Sir.
Okay.
The streams have collided.
So, world, John, interesting day at work today.
Today? Why were you working today?
Like I said, it was an interesting day at work today.
What happened?
The crossover line from the evaporators.
Yep.
Still had a like carbon steel high drain thing that decided to blow out this morning.
Ooh.
Wow.
Nice.
So I guess the furnaces are down.
Yep. We're getting one of them restarted.
Who's on days today?
Days today was Phil.
Oh, okay. So you had Dave there, at least.
Yep, had Dave and Alan, and Norm was working over.
Wow. Well, I mean, that's the first time we'd used that line.
Yep. And pretty sure that the plug was on the underneath the insulation up there.
Yeah.
But it's not like you had just seen it.
Right.
So we're not sure how much we threw up into the air, but.
Well, it probably wasn't a whole lot because that stuff's pretty potent. You can smell it as probably as soon as it started coming out, I'm sure.
Yeah, they're pretty sure that, it seemed to have happened like right at 4:10 or so. And Phil was coming in not long after that. So he heard something and started smelling something. And they were like, oh, well, shit. So apparently we can't win for losing.
It's always something.
And it always seems to be something Lauren left behind for us.
Yeah. That's the trend anyways.
tonight.
Did you end up getting Doom?
Man, what are you trying to do?
Do what with the Doom?
Have you played Doom?
The original one? Yes, I played a long time ago.
No, the new one.
No. Amanda, if we heard you, I'm pretty sure it was from your brother's microphone. And where's this mysterious other sister that is, like, you know, supposed to be making a guest appearance?
So quiet.
Let's just do it through roll 20.
She just has to pantomime all of her words.
Or if we can, Amanda, turn off your video, or just turn off your audio in Skype, and we can listen to you through roll 20. Try that.
I can't believe all the work you're making your brother do the day he graduates from law school.
She just has to run over to Ryan's computer every time she wants to talk and just talk into his mic.
And get all the notes. See how he's going to kill us.
I'm pretty sure it involves giant bats and fire.
Oh, no. Always, I mean...
Always involves fire.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, shoot. Cognar doesn't have any rages either.
Nope.
Oh, God.
Cognar's getting the shit kicked.
Hey. What was that movie from the 70s? The Raging Inferno or... Something like that. At an apartment building or big office tower, like caught on fire and people trying to escape.
Yeah, I think it's called Raging Inferno or something like that. Backdraft.
Backdraft?
That was like a 90s movie.
70s movie? It could have been like Tower Inferno or something. They had a lot of crazy names.
The Towering Inferno, there it is.
Hey, look at that. I wasn't even alive and I guessed it.
Well, neither was I. You know, movies are things that, like, you can see even if you weren't alive when they were made.
That's true. No comeback for that.
You could have just gone with the simple, but why would you want to?
But why would you want
to? To each their own, right?
There really aren't many movies made in the 70s that are worth watching.
Yeah.
So, Ryan, why aren't you drunk?
Working on it.
Funny is just being a pain. Evil place.
Amanda has never looked more serious. Or closer to murdering something.
That is terrible.
Didn't she give Lothar one of those looks at one point?
Maybe in the middle of, like, trying to make up all these lies that you never could remember you'd made up?
Actually, everybody else couldn't remember them and made up different lies for me. That's not my fault. I remember that one specifically. I came back and you're like, oh yeah, by the way, you said this. What?
That's what you get for being drunk and not being able to play.
Hey. I did all right. I take pride in the fact that I have not yet passed out while playing.
I'm not so sure about that.
I've come close, but I haven't actually passed out. I stopped talking.
You become unintelligible.
Yeah, that happens. A little slurry.
You know, I wonder if Zen and Amanda can hear us right now.
I think they can.
Maybe.
I don't think so. And I think they're making up all this, like, internet sound video problems just to allow them more time to plan for epic betrayal and murder of everyone else in the group.
That was in the cards, right?
I mean, she was really desperate to get back here.
I know, dude. She's gonna murder us all. And I just started playing!
That's alright. I got, like...
You think you just started playing?
Three characters.
Or Sean.
I know. I haven't even begun.
I'm not even convinced I'm not going to murder Sean's character myself, but we're not past...
Oh, no,
we're
not to that point yet. You're buddies.
We're not to that point yet.
I'm pretty sure...
Just because he used to be a grizzly bear is no reason to murder him.
See, we don't even know that part yet. He hasn't told us.
I know.
Apparently, I was really close to finding out.
Just 10 minutes away, right?
Just 10 minutes
away. By really close, do you mean 100 combat turns?
I could have lived.
Just had these guys raining down fireballs on you.
Taking no damage.
Then the guys with the crossbows show up.
Yeah, those are the guys. Those are the guys that'll kill me. Shit. Yeah, I need to remember danger sense, because that shit is overpowered with this build. I get advantage on dex saves. Advantage on dexterity saving throws against effects that you can see, such as traps or spells. So I get advantage on that. So I get advantage, and if I'm wielding the shield, then I take zero damage if I succeed. It's so awesome.
That's only if you see the trap, though, right?
Or a fireball coming at me. But yes, I have to see the trap. And or spell. But usually I can see where it's coming from.
Right until Mushi shoots you in the back.
Well, then I just don't have advantage. That's one thing that is kind of sucks about the mechanics of some of these things, but it's for the fun of the game. Someone wants to stab you in the back and you got something that won't let them, then, oh well, can't do anything. Although, if she really wanted to do that, she could just kill us in her sleep.
Who says she won't? Now that she's about to awaken the fire demons she wanted.
That's so true. Oh, man. So, sorry I had to leave early on Tuesday. The missus came home and I had to split.
Honestly, I was more surprised you were able to play on Tuesday.
Yeah, I was able to sneak in. So did we all die, or what?
Well, you did.
Oh, that's fine. Typical of my characters.
What is this, on another campaign?
Yeah.
It's creepy, man. I was only in there for like, what, an hour, two, maybe? Whew. Creepy stuff.
Yeah, Zen was starting a Tuesday night game for a bunch of his buddies that he grew up with. Supposedly, like, his sister, or his Amanda and his other sister. And basically, they never showed up. So he invited me to come over, like, to see if they could maybe make one more go of it.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, we can hear you.
Yeah?
No. We could hear you.
Oh, no. It finally started working. Did she leave?
We can hear her clear.
No. Oh. What?
Yeah, we heard that part too. Huh. I'm awaking a fire demon. Okay, let me fix that.
Oh my god, it's so upsetting.
You guys don't even realize, okay?
I'm back.
You don't even know.
You're short nails.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Wait, I just totally had those extensions put on. I spent all day painting them.
No, that's not right.
Been talking about his hair extensions.
I know.
No, my nail extensions.
Aww. Obvious.
Oh, man. I'm pretty sure if I got extensions, it would qualify as beard extensions, not hair extensions.
Depending on where you put them.
In my beard. Where would you put them?
Not in your beard. Okay. So, is Lucas there?
Yes.
Okay. Cool beans.
All right, set the scene for us.
All right, everybody roll me a d20.
Oh. 13.
All right, first roll of the night. 19.
Pick him down.
16.
2.
All right. Nick, would you like to begin by explaining what happened last session? Give it a little recap.
I would indeed. Last session, we fuck shit up.
All right.
We totally, yeah. I remember that. I remember that.
That's pretty much what we did. We killed ourselves a fire elemental. We finally killed that bastard of a priest that we met the very first time we got here at the beginning of the day. And we were able to get inside of the monastery with the scaffolding burning down around us. I almost got pushed off the ledge, but I was able to be saved by our good friend Cognar and Grubender. And then we met our friend, what is your character's name again?
Drago.
Drago, who was climbing up the side of a burning building. Very confused, not sure who he was, barely able to speak. Grubender had some mercy on him, let him up. We convinced him to help us out, and moved up the stairs to fuck some more shit up. And that is where we are.
All right. Beautiful, beautiful. So the party now resides...
And Grubender healed the shit out of everything he wasn't killing.
The party is currently on this floor that looks loosely like a bit of a barracks. With a dozen bedrolls scattered across the floor, these stone stairs they began ascending continue upward along the inside of the tower's northernmost wall. Yushi, who just made her way up from the kind of landing on the floor below, came to report is that the fire itself is spreading into the tower and slowly making its way up. And I believe that is where we are currently.
Oh. Okay, I think so.
Hey, just so everyone knows, this is the sister.
Hello.
This is her. This is her, right here.
Hi.
She exists. Okay, we're good now.
You know, you're right. You two are so identical that it would totally be reasonable to go on a date with someone who asked her out.
Yeah. We look the same. Talking about my
day with me. I think that was sarcasm.
You know, if it helps, I look almost exactly like Sean. If we had the same body type, we could probably pull it off.
Yep.
The old bait and switch.
Thank you. It happens.
Not Sean, but my little brother Sean.
Oh, wow.
I was going along with it. It's like you've never seen me before, but I'll roll with it.
Basically,
your picture looks a lot like you.
See, I can say that because all those people know my little brother, so it works.
We understand.
They know. They know.
We feel your pain.
It's okay. I look just like my sister, so I totally understand.
See, it's funny. My sister looks nothing like the rest of my family.
Uh-oh.
Like, she's got, like, dark skin and shit. We're all, like, pasty.
No man's kid.
FedEx.
FedEx. Special delivery. Alright. Okay, so we left getting healed up with the last of the candle, right?
Correct. That's correct. Cognar was going up the stairs.
And I was at getting full ready to HD.
And all I have is black screen.
Move up a little bit.
Oh,
hey, there we are.
We totally left off with Mushi saying we need to get the fuck upstairs.
So let me scroll back down.
Because Mushi thought
because she was on the phone. But that's what Mushi sees on the floor below. Mandy, you see that?
Yeah, that totally sucks.
Oh, you're trapped down there. Oh, no, you're not.
We need to go.
Okay, Cognar is running up the stairs.
All right. Dognar begins charging up the staircase. Does anyone choose to follow Dognar at this point?
Please.
Katrina.
I'll follow him.
Let her partner go. Katrina will pull up the rear then.
All right. I am following.
She'll push Drago in front of her.
I don't care where I am. I'm just not going to be last this time.
So they begin ascending the staircase, and Cognar is the first to see that this room, as he makes his way up, contains a bedroll, a desk, and a bookcase, kind of blocking off half of the room from this sight. At the wall he is at, the staircase no longer climbs upwards, but across the room he can make out a single figure seated at a large chair at the desk, who slowly turns around, puffing on a wooden pipe. As he turns, his eyes meet with Cognar's. He says, "Greetings, friend. I suppose it's best that we not spend our final moments alone. Please do come in."
Does he look like the cultist people that were down below?
His robes are somewhat crimson in color, and half of his face is very badly burned.
Badly burned. Okay.
Otherwise, he has gray wisps of hair, and half of his face is covered in a fairly respectable-looking beard.
Oh, wow. He's got to be evil. He's only got half a beard.
Katrina's gonna stealth so she can hide kind of in the stairwell.
Cognar's gonna run out.
I am going upstairs slightly to see what's happening.
Cognar begins running towards him and he says, "Please, there's no need for violence.
Oh no.
This tower is going up and we're all going down."
Yep, I hit him with my shield. Uh-oh. Hello?
Chris, putting your blade out.
Oh, that was weird. I lagged super hard.
Yeah, I got that too.
Yeah,
same here.
So Cognar... snaps his fingers, a small spark of flame appears at the tip, and he lowers it down into his wooden pipe that he begins slowly puffing upon before shaking his hand out.
So he just cast fire?
Just kind of a small spark that he lit what's in the tip of his pipe before kind of puffing.
I
want to
go upstairs.
It.
Please take me up there.
Okay,
the staircase is full.
I use my movement and I'm gonna ready my action if he is hostile. But I'm all up in his grill.
Alright. One second.
Dude, weird. I can see upstairs and downstairs at the same time.
Magic.
I am magic.
Should have just attacked him. Alright, so Ravenna begins slowly his way closer, kind of keeping his eyes about the room. You can see a wooden torch burns in the wall, providing light on this floor. As the man continues puffing upon his pipe, and he looks down to Cognard, he says, "So tell me, what brought you to the Scarlet Moon Hall?"
I choose silence.
As his eyes drift towards Grabender, he says, "Your friend's not very chatty, is he?"
He hasn't had enough to drink lately. Well, mainly we came to stop that thing going on in the sky.
Well, in that case, he kind of bites down on his pipe and slowly begins clapping, very visibly sarcastically. He says, "Well then, you have my congratulations. With the destruction of this tower, I'm sure the ritual will be far from its completion."
That's good news.
When the towers collapse, I'm afraid you will not see the rising sun. Nor will any of us.
Oh, that's good. I'm going to shoot him with my short bow.
All right. Katrina, go ahead and roll me an attack.
I haven't even gotten to talk to him yet.
Nope.
Yeah, I don't let him talk.
You don't need to ask him about where his pipe came from.
So I rolled a 23 on my stealth.
You don't know.
All right.
And then...
That's how we almost died.
Roll that attack with...
Oh, that's a 20!
Oh!
Go ahead and roll me one more D6.
Ace.
Yay.
That's 5 plus 7 plus 1. So that's 13 on the attack for the damage.
Yeah, sneak attack is double 2, though. So.
Oh,
yeah,
right.
Plus the 2.
Plus the 2.
For a total of 15. So this arrow whips across the room. It slams into the chest of this guy. He said, as he looks down, the arrow sticking out of his chest, he slowly stands up from the desk next to the dwarf, takes a deep drag of his pipe before saying, "Well then, so be it." And everybody go ahead and roll me some initiative.
10.
Yay.
Boys?
Right in the middle. Except for I have a ready to action.
17.
I always forget that I have this camera set up.
Nah.
I'm so used to using roll 20 that I forget that I can roll a dice if I want. It's okay. For initiative, it works well because it puts my token in the initiative order and everything.
You said 20?
Yeah, what do I roll for initiative?
You roll a D20.
Roll a D20.
Plus your deck.
Add your initiative.
Although, actually, you should be able
to just hit the dice.
Yeah. You should be able to select your token, your little picture on Roll 20, and up at the top there should be a little screen. Menu. And
how about
wait.
Currently a floor up below with Yushi right now. There-ish. As you and Mushi are kind of waiting on the staircase, as Katrina just fired off this shot before making her way up the staircase.
So if that was you who just moved your token?
That was me who just moved
it. It wasn't, but I've got it pulled up now where I can see my health and the red and blue circles above.
All right.
Okay, so can you see a menu up near the address bar on your screen?
Yeah. Initiative, okay.
Yep.
Woo. There you go. 18 for you.
Woo! Alright. We just lost the from the call.
Go over there and slap her.
What? Well,
I don't think Zen's internet is strong enough for two players.
I'm not sure Zen's apartment is strong enough. two players.
Yes. Well, while we're taking this brief intermission, I'm going to get some water.
Hey, who said you could leave?
And ever so slightly, Katrina angered Bender.
Anything go?
You see, the only thing you see is Katrina as she's kind of in the way of your ascending this staircase.
Holding her bow out, looking menacing.
And the first thing that happens is the guy immediately behind Cognar rises to action.
Now, I had a ready to action, and it dropped. My Skype dropped right when you were doing something.
Okay. So it's going to be as a reaction. Okay. So it's basically as soon as this turn goes off, you get your
sweet
reaction for him taking hostile moves.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Hit me.
So the small creature behind Cognar begins raking at him with his claws.
Yeah.
Attempting to attack, and I'm guessing a total of 11 is not going to hit.
Nope.
Cognar feels something tugging back at his pants as the wizard begins to turn and run in the direction of the right. So Cognar, you can go ahead and make your attack.
Oh, okay.
And then you will get your attack of opportunity for him leaving your threat zone.
Sweet. All right, so I'm making two swipes at Wizard Dude.
All right.
And I got a... Let's see, that's what, plus six? Yeah, plus six. So that is 14 and 13.
All right, so go ahead and roll me damage on one of those.
Plus three, because I'm not raging. Ah! 11.
All right. As you slice your sword across the retreating wizard, opening up a small wound at his back, as he begins running in this direction, before raking his arm in an upwards motion across parallel to the bookshelf, beside him, and as he does so, flames seem to erupt.
Oh god.
Out the floorboards.
Ah, shit. Alright, so who's the swipe at?
All up and down this room as a wall of fire occurs. I'm going to need Rebender and I believe Katrina to roll me, I think it's dexterity saves.
Even though I'm not. Is it because I'm right next to it?
I'm double checking now.
Isn't it only if you go through it?
Yes, I'm going to need dexterity saves from both Verbender and Katrina.
Aww.
Okay.
You good?
So I totally have an advantage on this, right?
I got a 14.
You do not, though, because the armor would give you disadvantage.
Oh. I rolled a 7, so let's see if I can get disadvantage on that. Oh, a 4.
Well done.
All right. So, Grabender and Katrina, what was your roll?
14.
All right, so both of you feel this immense blast of heat as this wall of fire erupts about the room, dissecting it in half. As both Rebender and Katrina take 20 points of fire damage.
Ooh, seriously?
Half to 10, right?
Half to 10 because Katrina's burn resistance. As well as the two individuals immediately before Grabender seem to stand in the fire, almost ignoring the flames completely.
Of course they do.
But with that, Katrina is up.
Can I get through the wall?
You can certainly try.
You know what? How high is this right here?
That is about 10 feet up.
And then this is like a table?
That is a bookshelf. So effectively, even if you climbed up the 10 feet, you would have a wall effectively right there.
I can't go this way.
Correct.
So I have to go through here.
Or you can go back down.
To the flames.
Retreat is always an option.
Wait, where'd that guy move? He moved again?
He moved back around the bookshelf.
Okay, I didn't get my opportunity attack on him. Do I get that?
Yeah, that was the second roll.
No, I get two attacks for my
first was your ready. The first was your ready to action. The second was your opportunity attack.
Right, I get two attacks, though, for my barbarian.
Okay, go ahead and roll me one more attack roll.
Okay, that's less than the other one that I rolled, so I don't hit. Oh my god, my dice hate me tonight. I thought I had the good ones.
Swings and a miss.
Yeah, okay, Katrina's going to dive through the flames.
All right, as you do so, you can feel the flames licking all about your person. And go ahead and roll me another dexterity save.
Okay. Come on, baby. 13.
All right, so once again, you can feel the searing pain of the flames as you dive your way through them, taking what would be 18 points of fire damage, half because of your resistance to 9 points of fire damage.
Okay. And it just costs regular amount of movement?
Right, regular movement. Okay.
Oh my god.
Skype. 15, 25, 30. Alright, so I'm going to go 30. I'm going to stabby that person right there with next to Grabender.
Alright.
Which is going to give me sneak attack with my short sword.
Alright.
I don't think it does.
Mm-hmm.
ichor is about coating your blade or slowly kind of evaporating into smoke.
All right, I'm going to stab him again.
All right.
So that's a 17.
17 is going to hit for a 11
so that's
slashing.
11, yep.
So then... as you slice your blade into him, as he lets out a sharp scream for his person, as he does so, he kind of explodes into this cloud of smoke. And everybody within 5 feet of him can no longer see.
Oh, shit. Like, just, like, one
like
second I'm hitting him, and 1 second the lights go out.
Total darkness. 1 second you are slicing into him, the next second you cannot see anything.
Okay. So what kind of, so I know that the other guy was right there. Can I just take the sword and try to swing it at him?
You can, but this is going to be a disadvantage.
Okay. Ooh, that's a one.
Swing, you cannot get me any lower with a disadvantage.
Okay, well then, I'm going to take one step back. I can't see the map. But, let's see, I have 10 feet of movement left, so I'm going to take... Yeah, I'm going to back up until I feel like the edge of the stairs.
Okay, 1 second.
And then I'll wait. I'll kind of crouch and wait.
Okay.
He doesn't get an attack of opportunity.
So as you step away, your vision is once again returned to you.
Oh.
Wow.
Well, that's good.
Does your attack have to land for your feet?
No, I just have to swing at it.
Have to attempt. Okay.
Yep.
All right. Anything else you would like to do?
That is it
as
for
you
me.
Retreat, and you can feel the descent of the staircase underneath your foot.
Okay, so she'll just stand at the edge.
All right. So, Drago, you can feel an immense flame coming from up above, as well as what sounds like the war cries from your dwarven buddy Kavnar, as well as Katrina has fled from her position that previously blocked your and Mushi's ascent. What would you like to do?
So all I can see is just Mushi in front of me. Can't get by her.
You can certainly get by her. And with 15 feet of movement, you can be upstairs if you would like.
Okay, I want to move upstairs.
All right. You're now ascending this staircase and finding yourself in a new room as this wall of fire seems to block your way further up the stairs.
Okay, can I cast the wind spell to make a pathway between the fire?
You absolutely can try.
Let's see. My character sheet's kind of lagging a little bit.
Alright, no worries.
So, gust of wind, is that the one you're thinking of?
There's another one. I believe it's a higher level. I think it's a level 3 spell, maybe? Wind wall? I don't know.
Alright.
Oh, you're going to counter his firewall with a wind wall. Woohoo.
So I can just hit the cast button associated with the spell, or...
I believe so, if it's all filled out.
Yeah, it's not filled out, but...
Okay. So, 1 second now. And you said the wind wall spell?
Yes.
Right.
can make the wall up to 50 feet long, 15 feet high, and 1 foot thick. You can shape the wall in any way, so long as you choose a path that is continuous along the ground. When the wall appears, each creature within it must make a strength saving throw. A creature takes 3d8 bludgeoning damage on a failed save, or half as much on a successful one.
Right, so...
Somehow I feel like I'm about to be murdered by my own companions.
It wasn't Cognar this time.
Does that make it better?
I don't know, does it?
It does say you can shape the wall in any way you choose, so long as it makes one continuous path along the ground.
So I'm just going to shape it directly from where my character is to the west, up the staircase, kind of like forming a cross with the firewall.
Like clearing the way immediately in front of you?
Yes.
Kinda like that?
You are going to engulf me in flames.
All right.
Is this like Backdraft, where, you know, it makes the flames hotter?
I would say one thing to think about, Sean. This is a concentration spell, so if you keep concentrating on it, even if you try to move through it, you'll probably take the damage.
And with concentration spells, whenever you take damage, you have to basically make a roll to see if the spell is maintained.
So it's basically channeling, then.
Right.
What you might try, you also have protection from energy. You could give yourself fire resistance, and then you'd only take half damage from moving through it.
Okay. All right, is my movement up, though? Can I still move?
I think you have 15 feet left, right?
Well, first of all, what I'll do, because...
15 feet. So three more squares.
Cast the wind wall to be able to cast protection from energy.
I'll just cast protection from energy and try to move up the stairs.
All right.
Completely. Like.
And I'm guessing you're selecting fire for your resistance to the spell.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe.
All right.
I think here cold is probably what it needs.
Yeah, right.
Take a moment to kind of focus upon the flames licking about nearby on the staircase. And after a moment's concentration, the flames don't seem to be nearly as smoldering hot as you successfully cast this protection from energy spell. And with that, you can attempt to walk through the wall of fire. And as you do so, can you roll me a dexterity save?
So the dexterity save is back on your core page.
Core. Okay, and that's the heart?
Yep. That's the one.
Mom, Dex Heart.
No!
Right.
Only the order to be reversed.
You focus upon yourself as you begin stepping through this wall of fire. And as you do so, the flames aren't nearly as hot as they should be, but you do still feel a bit of a pang to them.
Burning sensation?
It's getting a little hot for you. But with your resistance, you only take 10 points of fire damage. And with that, can you roll me a concentration check?
He can make one more square, right?
Or a constitution check.
We did the concentration check.
There it is. Awesome. Terrific.
Hey, look at that.
As you've maintained this focus upon the fiery flames, choosing to kind of resist their This is no. the heat that is happening.
Protection from energy is not concentration. He just has it for the next 8 hours. Because that's why you guys still have it.
On 270, I've got it as being concentration.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
Oops.
Ragnar, I thought, drank a potion or something like that.
I don't remember what happened. That was so long ago. What did you actually give us?
Ragnar drank that potion the genie gave him. The hero potion or whatever.
Yeah, but that's not where his fire resistance is coming from.
But no, that is where his fire resistance is coming from.
Oh.
Yours is coming
Mine's
from me.
Coming from Grabender. Yeah.
And I'm guessing that concentration roll means Katrina just loses hers?
That would be my guess.
Yes.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
So Katrina, as you're standing there, the flames begin to grow hotter around you. But, Drago, is there anything else you would like to do at this point in time?
What can I do? Like, I'm still unsure.
If you have any spells you can cast as a bonus action, you could do that. Otherwise, I believe you used your full movement to kind of make it up the stairs, and then you used your action to cast the protection from energy spell.
Okay, and I'm ending my turn.
You can healing word Katrina.
Can I?
don't waste a spell on that.
All right,
Jeez, shots fired.
Where you stand, you can continue to feel the flames licking about you.
You don't say.
Cannot see anything.
Oh, don't. Double win.
Okay, well, I want to move, like, I saw the room before it all went dark, so okay. I want to move out of the flames towards the wall over here.
All right. So, go ahead and click your token, and can use the arrow keys. I'm not sure if it works for you guys or just for me. Terrific. So that's 5 feet movement right there.
Yep.
Oh, that is cool.
So I'm I can't go any further. I'm still trying to click.
Okay.
I think someone trapped me.
What? Nah.
It's okay. All right. See.
As you continue making your way towards the western wall, all of a sudden your sight is returned to you, and you are standing almost immediately next to this smoky creature that was summoned.
Okay, well, now that I can see again, I want to smash that thing in the face.
All right.
Do it.
Go ahead. That is going to hit. And that's 6 bludgeoning, right?
Yep.
Okay. As you whip your mace around, it slams into the side of this smoky creature. Once again, a small spattering of this black ichor flies from his mouth as your mace makes contact with it, landing about on the carpet below him, before slowly evaporating into smoke and dissipating about the room.
Oh, God.
Kind of blending in with the smoke from downstairs, as well as the fire. Anything else you would like to do?
Yeah, I doubt these guys speak Celestial, but in Celestial I'm going to say, flee or die.
All right. And he looks to you and begins chattering in a language I don't believe you understand.
I don't think any of us have.
Do asshole.
Yeah. That sounded amazingly like Goblin.
Well, I don't know what. I don't even have a reference as to what these languages might sound.
They sound like the elements of which they come from.
Precise.
Yeah, it's going to be.
Are they fire elementals or are they smoke elementals?
Guess you'll find out when you get upstairs.
Yeah, you don't even know what they are. You haven't seen anything yet. My turn's over.
All right. Mushi, you can hear quite a bit of commotion happening upstairs. What would you like to do?
I suppose I'm going to go downstairs. No, I'm going to go upstairs.
All right. So 10 feet of movement gets you to there.
Okay. Yeah. Lovely. Firewall.
No, please don't.
Can I go up here?
You, if you can climb up there. Currently, it's about 10 feet that you would have to climb before pulling yourself up into that small little space.
I would like to try and climb up to that small space.
All right, go ahead and roll me a strength, or, sorry, an athletics check.
Oh, great. Negative two.
Oh.
17.
Hey.
All right, so Mishi successfully pulls her.
Yo, I didn't see that on the camera. How can we trust her?
You just 20 cut feet out on me.
I just had to
have two squares of movement if you would like.
No, thank you.
The flame—you can feel the flames present next to you, though you have resistance because of your tiefling bloodline. It is getting pretty hot.
Can I still see this guy, even though there's the block of darkness right there?
You cannot.
Oh, damn!
I believe you have Dragon's sight right now. Yeah.
Aww.
It hasn't fixed yet. Give it a second. Then you can say, ah.
Get me right in here.
That's what
I'm already naked.
No, I still have a sight then. If you said there, it's still there. There we go. Okay.
Yeah, so it just took a second.
Damn. Okay.
That's what
and
you
I don't see.
Anything you
else?
Climb your way up this little wall as you were ascending the staircase, and you can see pitch blackness almost cutting off this flame that's blocking off the ascent of the staircase. And you can see Drago, Katrina, and Grubender all up on this floor. No sign of Cognar.
Can I cast Ray of Frost on the flame?
You can certainly try.
Well, why not? Because I can't see anyone and I'm not about to walk into a flame. I'm a squishy.
Oh.
It's a worthy try, guys.
I'm not sure what you said, because on my end you just
it was worth trying.
Robot. That's go ahead.
It was a worthy try.
Roll me an Arcana check.
Woohoo.
Oh,
I mean,
I'm supposed to be good at these, but I never am.
I don't think you've ever made one, have you?
19.
Oh my god.
As you begin focusing on the flames before you, you cast this ray of frost, and a beam of white light emanates from the palm of your hand in a very Iron Man-like fashion. And where the beam would normally end after a moment, after successfully freezing your enemy, you take a moment and concentrate and focus and pinpoint the floor specifically in front of you. And after another moment, as the flames continue to burn, they slowly sizzle away for an instant.
Oh.
And in that instant, I would like to walk by, please.
All right. As you continue running by the flames, anything else you would like to do?
That was epic.
No. I'll continue moment.
Is that a no?
Yeah, that's a no.
Okay. So, Grubender, the little fella that's immediately next to you continues this chanting and muttering in a language you're not quite sure what it is. Before he opens his mouth and kind of stomps on his chest, pounding it in a very King Kong-like fashion. And as he does so, puffs of cloud begin slowly emanating forth from his mouth in a pattern that looks strikingly similar to this. And I'm going to need Drago and Katrina both to roll me a dexterity save.
Oh, okay, give me a second. And Sean had to take off to help put the kids to bed and stuff, so I'm going to blame his character for the rest of the night.
Okay.
Oh, no. That's bad. That's really bad, guys. I don't have fire resist anymore either.
Yeah.
Well, it's okay. It's smoke and smoldering ashes in this cloud of not so nice.
Dexterity save, right?
Yes. All right. So Drago takes a moment to raise his cloak about his face. Kind of more interested in protecting the moneymaker as he does so. As Katrina whips around to see what all this chattering's about, she gets an eyeful of this burnt ash in her eyes, and she is effectively blinded. As the chanting and chittering continues.
Well, you guys better be able to finish this fight without me, because I am done.
Creature runs forward.
Oh, shit.
There.
Blinded Cognar. Sucks. Yes.
You are up.
Cognar is running. All right. So, since he does have some kind of wrist distance on him, he's not so afraid of the fire. And that's what I'm saying, because that's what I feel like saying.
All right. First story.
Yeah, that's my story.
All right, Cognar, can I get a dexterity
great, you're running away from him.
Yes. And do I see that spell? As I'm running through it.
What? For fire?
Yes.
The wall of flame?
Yes, I see that, right?
I would presume yes.
Okay, danger sense gives me advantage on it. Woohoo! That's 19, 21.
All right, and I believe with a successful save because of your shield, you take no damage.
Yep.
Basically, he wait, no, I've got it. He runs, throws his shield on the floor, and like slides across the wall on his shield.
Yes.
He effectively has created the world's very first snowboard.
Yes.
As he leaps upon it, sending sparks flying about the wood behind him as he goes, continuing his leap through the flames with a roll, re-grabbing his shield and standing upright immediately in front of this individual that is currently fleeing.
So that's 25, 30, 35. And I'm going to do the old 1-2-3 combo. Attempt to prone him with the shield, first and foremost.
All right.
Yes.
Kill the Captain America really, that.
I know, that was so epic. 23.
23. All right. Yeah. And this is strength, right? Strength or
strength.
Athletics or acrobatics or just straight up strength?
Let me check the feet. I think it is a strength save, but I will double check. Shield.
Because it's a difference of plus one. But that plus one is going to be important in this case.
It's under the freaking combat maneuvers. Of course. It's not under the feet where it should be. Where are you dashing? Where's the shove and things? Oh, shoving a creature.
Athletics check athletics. Contested by this.
Yeah, athletics.
By the target's athletics or acrobatics.
Oh, did he make it?
He didn't make it.
Really?
As he stands 23? Strong, right. As you slam about him with your shield, he stands in place.
All right, two swipes with the longsword.
What would you like to do? All right.
17.
That's going to hit.
All right. Roll the second. Natural 20!
Beautiful.
All right, so we'll roll the regular first.
All right.
All right, so that's 2-5 damage on the first one. And the second one, which is the natural 20, double the dice. Nice. 16, 19 damage on the second.
All right.
And he has to make two concentration checks.
Real quick, what was the first damage?
I want to say 5.
5 total?
Yeah, 5 total.
Okay, and the second you said was 19?
Yes.
All right.
And I hope he has some concentration checks.
This is totally what's going on right now.
What page is that?
More or less.
Page. I want to see.
Page 191.
Oh, well, are you talking about me jumping onto the fire dude?
Yeah.
I was going to say,
raging,
I kicked that
chasing
guy.
The fire guy.
I kicked that guy off the, you know, the second floor.
I don't think you kicked that guy. He's a lot bigger than the guy you kicked.
That's true. Anyway. That's it. That's my turn.
Is it? When you take damage, it's equal to 10 or half the damage. Is that right?
Whatever's greater.
Because he rolled 2 11s. So, I know it would beat the normal on the first one. He succeeded on the second one, also an 11.
I don't have to deal with concentration checks, okay. So I don't know.
Or half the damage you take. So he does pass.
Yeah, both. Passes both.
Okay.
I tried.
Anything else you would like to do?
No, that's it. I mean, I gave him a good making. Right.
Indeed. He's going to remember that one.
Of course he will.
As these small creatures on the other side of the bookshelf begin moving closer to the party, first leaping over towards Grubender right about here, and he swipes Grubender with his tiny little claws, and Grubender feels absolutely no impact as the claws are raked across his armor. The claws are left embedded in the armor as his hands continue downward, effectively declawing this creature with his natural one roll.
He should do that again.
As Katrina senses something moving through the flames immediately next to her, what is Katrina's AC?
15.
So Katrina feels a rake of claws coming from somewhere. She's not immediately sure where, but it's almost like the fire itself is clawing at her as she takes... have any of the right dice.
Man, this is
brutal. Whopping 5 points of slashing damage. As the man nearest Cognar raises his hand and places it upon Cognar's shoulder.
Oh, shit.
Cognar, I need you to roll me a constitution save.
Oh, shit.
As you feel a surge of energy coursing from his hand and rapidly spreading about your person.
That's a 22.
22. Shaking it off the best you can, you recoil, slapping his hand from your shoulder as you feel a surge of 15 points of necrotic damage. Half to 7 points of...
Why?
No, not half because you're not raging. So 15 points of necrotic damage.
Okay.
As you feel a slight coldness about your very soul.
Okay.
Before he lets out a slight chuckle, places his hand that was moments ago on your shoulder to his chest. And you can see the wound that you just inflicted beginning to slowly seal itself shut.
What the shit? Really?
As he continues around you. And with that, Katrina is up.
Oh, we're playing this game? We're going to dance around the... Oh, God.
I'm going to wildly slash whatever hit me.
All
I'm
right.
I'm blind and can't do shit.
Go ahead and roll me an attack with disadvantage.
Can you, like, wash out your eyes or something?
Oh, that one might hit. Oh, that one might hit too. So that's a 20 and a 22 on the long swords.
Oh, that's right. You get a plus three right now.
Mm-hmm.
They indeed are going to hit for 12 and then
11.
11. As you slice your blade, you can feel nothing on the first swing of your short sword. As you take the second swing with your long sword, you can feel it slicing through something ever so slightly. And using your reflexes, you focus upon that point of impact and stab with your long sword once again. As you do so, you can feel a burst of something at the tip of your sword. And once again, a cloud of darkness surrounds this area. As Mushi, the dark cloud that was moments ago across the room has just made its way ever closer to you.
Then Katrina's going to shout out, "I can't see! All I feel is the flames! Somebody help!"
I can't see!
She's going to... Can I save my movement until somebody helps move me?
I'll say sure.
That's okay. Basically like... No, yeah. Cool.
Alright, so that's what I'm going to do.
Alright. Drago.
Okay. Drago is not really down with all this shit going on in front of him. And so he's going to fall back on his basic druid training.
Sorry, one moment. Katrina, can you roll me a dexterity save? As you can feel the intense flames surging nearby you once again.
Well, that's why I was going to... Well, if that's going to happen, then I'm just going to move away from them on my turn.
Okay.
Yeah, because like that's what I was trying to avoid, was taking more fire damage from the wall.
So it's essentially so, whenever you end your turn,
okay,
that's when this happens. So,
well, then I'm going
like to
try to
stumble towards?
Away from the fire. I can feel where the fire is. I'm going to move away from the fire.
All right, you begin taking a step back as you step into something that is in that space. Bumping up against it.
Is it
effectively that space is person? Occupied.
Occupied. Occupied.
You are, is it one of my friends?
Not quite sure what it is. You are not sure, but you cannot see.
Okay, well, I'm gonna try to can I make an acrobatics check and or a athletics check
you
and just
effectively roll through that space?
Through? Yeah, just kind of like tumble through.
Yes, sir.
Is there a tail? Right.
So that's a 10. That's a 10. That's a dive away from fire.
I was using that as a dive through its space.
That's fine.
As your bender Katrina rolls about on the floor before impacting up against the wall with a slight thud that draws your attention towards you. No, she doesn't disappear.
That's what I'm saying.
I just can't see.
Right. She's here.
She's totally there, yeah. Okay. So, Drago, falling back on his basic druid training, figures that if they're made of fire, they must not like poison. Ooh, damn.
What is that, Pokemon? That's good poison damage.
And is this against the guy closest to him?
Yeah.
All right. Constitution save.
That's a good roll. They don't have a lot of health.
And that's 18 poison?
Yeah.
Yep.
Drago takes a moment to conjure up this small cloud of poisonous gas before firing it off in the direction of this small little creature that has made its way uncomfortably close towards him. And as he fires it directly in the face of this creature, the creature seems to stand there and take the full force of this gaseous poison, inhaling deeply as it does so, and quickly spitting what remains of the misty poisonous gas to the ground at his feet. He looks up at Drago and sneers, continuing to speak in this foreign language to the party.
Immune to poison.
I guess that didn't work. That was a good roll, too. Okay. Well.
Anything else Drago would like?
He has a scimitar. That counts as a light weapon, right?
Yes, it does.
So he can attack as a bonus action?
Yes, sir.
It's no modifiers to the damage, right?
Oh, yeah. No modifier.
Okay, so that's actually an 8, then.
No. It's no modifiers to the
damage. No modifier on the damage.
Oh, okay.
12?
So 2 damage.
Doggies!
If it hits. Okay,
so 12 is going to hit for 2 damage as he rakes the scimitar across the smoky figure that just spat out his spell that he cast. Anything else you would like to do?
No, I think that's going to be it for Drago.
Right. Bender.
Okay. I can't see Cognar, can I?
You cannot. You saw him do an amazing move where he basically threw his shield down and skidded across the flames like it were a skateboard. If you knew what a skateboard was.
Right, yeah, obviously.
He successfully surfed the flames.
Okay. I guess I'm just going to attack then, because I really want to see Cognar before I cast this other spell. So, I'll go ahead... You know what? I'm going to step up to there.
Alright.
Swing at that guy.
Alright. This is going to be with advantage, because of the flanking. The beautiful crack of your mace, it slaps into the back of this creature's head with a soft thud, leaving a small imprint behind as you draw it back.
And then I'm going to step back over here.
Alright. Anything else you would like to do?
Nope.
All right. And with that, Mushi's broke once again, so I will see what's up.
Aww. All right.
Strategy. Just tell her to come. Well, she can't sit in there with you.
Strategy. How do I keep this guy from leaving?
So, not that I would know this, what does the other part of the room look like?
Looks the same as the first part of the room, except for there's a ladder going up.
Stand on the ladder.
That's what I'm thinking. Do I have enough movement? That is the question. 10, 15, 20, 25. Okay, good. I have enough movement to try to knock him prone, hit him twice, and then move into the ladder.
Sounds like an excellent plan.
Yeah. I mean, he's running like a bitch, so he can't be too strong.
I don't know.
I mean, he did pass a freaking 26 constitution save. But I think Zen rolled really
high. Yeah, I think he rolled really high with his he had athletics or whatever.
Like a 19 on that, and he was trained in athletics or something. I have a feeling Zen's going to get tired of my bullshit. They're all trained in athletics so they can pass your strength save. Anyway. Yeah. I really need it. I don't think I can get a D10 one-hander, can I?
I'll tell you. Yeah. Okay, 1 second. Okay.
No. Just make her sit in there with you.
That's exactly what I'm doing right now. Because for whatever reason, the laptop is saying no internet over there. So,
did you plug it in?
She broke it.
Oh, that's what you gotta do.
Did you turn it off and turn it back on? That's what IT tells me all the time.
Did you turn it off and on again?
Okay.
It's like, yes, I did that. It's still broken. You asshole.
That is the most fundamental step to IT help. Of course we did that.
What would you like to do?
Where's the on button?
I just this guy and then I'll put it in the corner. You want to do the rolls?
I'll just do it all that way. I'll leave
it here. Critical hit.
Critical hit and critical damage.
Critical damage, yeah. Too.
Critical damage.
20 damage? Shit. Wow, DM needs to roll her dice more often.
So takes a moment to focus before firing off this ray of frost that she that successfully made her escape the flames all of time a moment ago. Taking her time to focus upon this individual small little creature cursing at the party from unknown point. As she takes a moment to focus, the creature itself seems to slowly freeze the inside out before bursting into this cloud of smoke around the party as Mush's visibility about the room drops. Very, very, very.
I think it's funny that the fire sorcerer we have does way better with ice spells.
And Mush, you will be a dexterity save. The flames behind you once again go through the little path you had.
So
you are going to take...
Just out of curiosity, did the guy that Lucas was beating on, did he have to make like a concentration check for that firewall?
He passed. Hey, I did 19 damage, and it still wasn't half the DC, so...
So guys, wall of fire is 5d8 damage. And I'm so glad I have someone here to observe this. Every single die rolled was an 8. She managed to pass her dexterity save, which halves the damage to 20 fire damage, down to 40.
Wow!
I just dropped that down
to 10. Wow! That is...
That's crazy!
That was a beautiful roll.
You wasted it on the person, the worst person to do it on.
No, that's perfect. That's a good thing.
Hey, it's right. A lot better than happening to Grabender.
And that guy
that's
is...
true. That's the one thing you're weak against right now with spells, isn't it?
So, about the whole vision thing, like, why is the entire room black except for this one little section I'm in?
Because the creatures seem to keep exploding, and as they do, this cloud of dark dust spews about where they stood, effectively creating a small bit of darkness around the area.
Don't we have a wild red?
Yep. I believe you have the
pink. I don't know if I do. I didn't see it. I'm sorry.
The wind fan.
Yep.
I don't see the wind.
Speaking of magic.
She has it, though.
Speaking of magic so you have items. Yeah. Speaking of magic items. Copy that. So I've got a thing, too.
Okay, Cognar, what would you like to do?
I'm just trying to see if I want to do something stupid.
Always.
It's kind of how you roll, man.
It is kind of how I roll. I'm just wondering if I want to use this thing right now, because I just remembered I had a magic item.
If it explodes, though, you take 50 damage. And you're not raging.
I can take it, though. I could bring the whole building down on us, too. I probably shouldn't do that. Cognar's not that dumb.
You guys are already working on that.
Yeah, he's there. All right, so... I moved through the square, but I'm actually going around them. Same thing. I'm going to do the shield. I'm going to attempt to do the shield. So that should be a plus 6 for this. Yes, plus 6.
Roll high.
Woohoo! That's a 20 total.
20 total?
Yeah.
As he falls down upon the impact of the shield.
Okay. Two swipes with advantage. Nice. That's a 18-24 on the first. I think my Skype's broken again. And a natural 20.
Hello? Yes? All right.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Sorry, you fell prone, and you do get attack with advantage.
Okay, I rolled a 24 and a natural 20.
Beautiful. Go ahead and roll me some damage.
Okay, damage. All right, so the okay. First one is regular D8 plus 3. So that's
Ben,
seven.
If you can hear me still, it just did the same thing to us. We thought it was our end.
Seven.
You said seven?
Yeah. Oh, yes! I did it again. Another 19 on the second.
Yeah, let's see him keep the concentration
checked.
So
seven and 19. He has to roll an 11. Or a 10 or higher, right? Oh, they're breaking. The world is breaking. Can you hear me? Oh. Oh.
Hello?
Hello.
Okay, so that call failed for the other four people in this call.
Oh.
But
sorry, that was weird. Like, Skype is, like, failing utterly.
Yes.
Not doing it today. Cognars, you rake your sword across him and then stab it deep into him. He lies down on the floor in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
The wall of fire, the heat across the way, you're coming through that wall, emanating, reflecting across a bright light, seems to dim before fading.
Yes. Sweet.
Anything else you would like to do?
Yes, I'm going to use the rest of my movement.
All right.
To stand on the ladder thing behind me.
Like begin climbing a couple of rungs, or?
I'm
or just standing
I'm,
in front of it.
Yeah, I'm standing in front of it. I'm going to block him from escaping.
All right.
That's my turn. I think if Ben can, you can hear us. Whatever works for you, I can listen to both Skype and Roll20. So. If your sound works better on Roll 20, to use it. I just can't use it because my computer is a piece of shit. But my dice, it's a beautiful die.
What did you do? Because I lost your eyes. You were attacking stuff.
Oh, I got a 24 and a natural 20, and I maxed my damage again. And he dropped his fire spell.
Oh, thank goodness!
And he's on the floor. And I'm.
That's what you just see.
Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah, those have been some amazing shield rolls without advantage, though.
I know. Who needs rage? I mean,
right? Not this guy.
This die right here, natural 20 on my last two attacks with it, so I'm happy with it.
I've been rolling the same smoky die.
I know. It's a wonderful die, isn't it?
Yeah. And, okay. You know, thematically with the red and the smoke.
I know. I threw my red into the abyss because it's a big jerk. It's in the timeout dice bin.
All right. So Mushi and Drago can hear something softly impact the staircase next to them. Something about the cloud around them. Or Drago feels the swipe of something. Rapidly.
Oh god. Is something coming up the stairs? I'm over here in La La Land.
Drago's AC.
Drago's AC. I'm pretty sure it's Sanus Grabender, so 28.
Oh.
I'm at 14.
14. So he can feel something slam into him from the right side. Leaving a heavy imprint, nearly knocking him off his ass down to the ground as this happens. He takes a split second to recover himself as he takes... numbers... 10 points of bludgeoning damage and 6 points of fire damage.
Oh, it's the dwarf! Oh shit, it's the dwarf I kicked out.
Of course it's the dwarf.
I'm sorry.
And Grabender, the little guy immediately in front of you, once again, takes this moment to try and attack you, now with disadvantage, no longer having the claws about his fists, as he begins just kind of pummeling down at your feet. And knowing your AC is ridiculously high, I'm assuming his decent rolls still aren't going to hit. With a 21 and a 20 total.
Nope.
He needs they basically a natural 20 to hit you. He's
kind of flailing about your person. Down at your little feet. Cognar, you can watch as the robed individual slowly stands himself back up, brushes some of the blood and grime off his robes. As he does so, you can watch some of the wounds about his person slowly sealing themselves back up.
What's up? Before
he looks to you and he says, "Very well, then. If this is the fate you have chosen, then so be it." And he reaches down to his belt, where there's nothing there, but as he rakes his hand back upwards, there's a flaming blade.
Oh, shit.
Now in his hand, in the shape of a scimitar, as he comes charging towards you.
Ah!
Making it to right about there, and with that, Cognar, what is your AC?
18.
18.
Yes.
You can feel the rake of this fiery blade splitting open your stomach as this happens. And you are going to take 11 points of fire damage.
Half, right?
Half. Because of your current resistance to 5 points of fire damage.
That's it.
And
oh, it's a sword of flame.
Sword of flame. Oh, yes.
Thank God.
And with that, Katrina is up.
Can I rub my eyes and try to get the blindness out?
You can certainly try. Go ahead and roll. Constitution? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's only 10.
So Katrina begins kind of flailing about her eyes, fairly kind of worried at this point as to what might have happened. And she feels like she's pulling something away from her eyes, but her vision doesn't.
Well, that's, I'm just going to keep doing that, because that's about all I can do.
All right. And with that, Drago is up. He finds himself in a, surrounded by darkness.
Well. So something just came out of nowhere and, like, smacked him on the side.
Something seems to be in the darkness that just did a pretty heavy hit up against him.
We don't know what these guys are packing yet, either.
Well, let's see. I guess he's going to what is he going to do? Now, he's a half-elf, I believe. Mm-hmm. He already has dark vision up to 60 feet. That doesn't help him at all in this.
Not seem to be helping him right now, no.
Okay.
So, he's So he would immediately know that whatever darkness is currently obscuring his vision is somewhat magical in nature.
Okay. He's going to Gust of Wind.
All right. And where would he like to place that?
That way.
All right. He cast it between down
there. Basically, kind of at whatever he thinks just hit him.
Right. I have no explain to Amanda. Be all night.
Oh. It's not like she can tell us.
He can make out a sight that looks strikingly like this guy.
Hmm.
You see, that's what you see in the staircase right next to you.
Oh, man.
And he looks rough. Like, his metal exterior is very bad. Scratched and kind of dinged in what you saw before. He no longer wields the shield that he had. Hoggarn knocked him down, but he's got this warhammer ripped out his arm, and it is just burning, this fiery light.
Well, that's good. His AC's down too. That's great.
And, oh, hey there.
And he's damaged because he fell down. So
that reminds me on Drago's. Last, when he got hit, I think it was 15 total damage that he took.
Oh.
He's got some fire resistance, right?
Yeah, he's got fire resistance, so.
So the first bit of it was bludgeoning, the second bit was. If you did the full damage, add 3 back to it, because it was you rolled full fire damage on his attack.
Okay.
Woohoo. Hey, 3 health.
But additionally, can you roll me a constitution save at a track?
Damn it. Huh?
All right, no problem. So after casting this gust of wind, effectively blowing away the residual, what remained of the kind of smoky creatures nearby, revealing this fiery dwarf, fiery metallic dwarf, next user. Anything else Drago would like to do at this point in time?
Well, doesn't Gust of Wind make like the line thing and he has to make a strength save or not get or get thrown back?
Yes, he does. What is the DC for Drago's spells?
Drago's spells should be DC of 14.
DC of 14. Right. Not a 12 total.
Back down the stairs with ye.
Flying back down the stairs. This poor kind of regaining footing and flaring up the staircase.
And more bludgeoning damage from falling for him.
Both Yushi and Drago do get an attack of opportunity at this point.
Sweet.
Hit him with your stick.
Alright. You want me to roll on here? Or, okay.
This is my boomstick.
Oh!
So it looks like you have a dagger, but no quarterstaff.
Remember, it was the spear or the javelin that he chopped the end off that turned into a sheet.
I'm not supposed to be doing your character sheet. Unbelievable. Oh, that's the quarterstaff.
Quarterstaff is a D.
Oh, it's a D.
It's a D. It is the D. No, I think it's a D6 and then a D8 if held in two hands.
Yeah, I wanted to say D6 too.
D6. Yep.
I'm D6. Sure if you're holding one or two hands. All right.
Of course she's going to grab it with two hands. Hiya! That's the good thing about being a spellcaster. Take your hand off. Put your hand back on. Take your hand off.
Is there
any
kind of fire still going?
Wall of fire is gone.
Wow.
Dude, wait.
Wow.
Wait. Is that That's minimum numbers for everything. That doesn't seem right.
Well, that's a 2 on the 2D on a D6, reduced by 2 because of Mushi's strength, if one-handed, or a 6 reduced by 2 to a 4, as well as rolling 2D10.
Oh, no, it says rolling 0D0 plus 1D6 plus minus 2. I'm confused.
Because I got a 1 and a 1 on rolling.
I think it worked right.
You sure?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think her damage is so low.
Yeah,
she has a minus 2 strength.
I know,
she has
a minus I'm just 2
and
it's...
she only rolled a 2.
He just managed to roll 0. 3 ones.
Yeah. Yep. Sorry, it just
shit happens.
I guess so. Holy shit! I'm just not.
She just really doesn't know how to use her stick. Okay.
I like watching sick birds. It's still got roots on it and everything.
But the scimitar does hit for 3 slashing, and
well, would that be main hand, not offhand? By chance. So it'd get modifiers.
That was with his modifiers.
Yeah.
Oh, 3 is?
He rolled a 2 on a D6.
Oh.
Plus 1.
I'm not used to seeing someone roll that low for a melee damage. I'm sorry. It's not a specialty.
So, Mushi, you would take 6 fire damage as you swing your quarterstaff at him. Have 2, 3. And Drago takes 4 fire damage, have to 2, upon making impact with his scimitar. He fiery, as his scimitar kind of rakes across his back, flames erupt from the metal, burning Drago ever so slightly.
And he did almost as much damage to himself by hitting.
Yeah.
Okay, well, he's just going to maintain that. Actually, he's going to take 1 step back and maintain that wall of fire, or...
Did you take fire damage?
Wall of wind.
Because I've got you at
47.
I
didn't
hear the number. Yeah.
Talking to me or to her?
To her, sorry.
I don't think her turn's come back up again, right?
No, it was about the wall of fire damage on the last round.
Oh.
Because she was still at full health, so I wasn't sure at what point she dropped out. Okay. Anything else Drago would like to do at this point in time?
Pretty sure it's all he can do.
All right. Rubender.
Okay.
As clouds of dirt and grime and smoky ash are kind of blown away, you saw for a split second the opponent that you guys faced a couple of floors below.
What about this general area?
Which one? That is still kind of remaining in darkness.
Okay. Just wanted to be sure.
Cloud of smoke is all about. Actually, I believe Drago would take the full 4 points of fire damage because Gust of Wind is a concentration spell.
Oh. Yeah.
Just add damage to that.
Bummer.
Better remember what's concentration and what's not.
We need a nap.
Right. Rubender, what would you like to do?
Rubender's going to step to there and attack this thing again.
Right. That is going to hit.
Hey, finally nice. Did some decent damage.
Bludgeoning damage. You swing your mace like a madman. You make impact on his head, nearly kind of ripping it off just from the impact. As his head kind of remains there, lopsided, the smoke kind of slowly seeps from the head down to his body, reformulates the neck, kind of in a makeshift manner, not nearly as sturdy as it was before, but he is still standing.
Okay. I'll just take the opportunity attack.
Right. He swings his nubs. Disadvantage. And I'm guessing a 3 plus 24. Is that going to hit?
If it was plus 24, it would.
Yeah, he just got super powerful. But no, he swings and continues to just kind of beat his nubs on the base of your armor.
Mind
you. Don't even recognize it as you continue your stride past it.
It's like Power Rangers. Okay.
Growl.
I think that's pretty much all I can do right now.
We're doing good, guys.
Right. We think.
I don't know what's going on over there. I'm doing good on this side of the bookshelf.
I killed one of those smoke things right. Without even being able to see.
That is pretty baller. I'll say that.
Okay.
If I go up to the other corner again and he comes up the stairs, will he hit me? That 55 feet from the ledge.
Because he's ascending, but he gets closer as he goes up. That's your last. You went.
Just go there and shoot him with ice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that my turn to flame damage?
No, that was. Yeah.
Okay.
And shoot him with ice.
Yeah, I'm going to. I'm going to do the.
All right.
Because that's been working fantastically tonight.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, Lucas.
What?
All right.
I was just convinced you were going to jinx that.
I have nothing but good things. I'm on fire tonight. You should be taking my compliments. Literally on fire?
As she fires off this bolt of cold energy from the palm of her hand, it slams into the small dwarf that has just tumbled down the base of the stairs, impacting him for 11 points of cold damage.
I'm not looking.
Anything else you would like to do?
Do it again.
She doesn't have the twin spell, right?
No. I do have a twin spell, but it's 2 sorcery points, only have 1.
Can't you sack spell slots for sorcery points?
She doesn't have any of those either.
Oh, well, never mind.
We're pretty well tapped, and yet we're still fighting.
I thought it was 2 for 1 spell.
Yeah.
We, well, I mean, that tells you that we must be doing something right tactically if we're surviving on nothing, right?
Yeah, I mean, like, we really have very little resources and we're doing fairly well.
I ran out of my resources before we came into this tower.
Yeah, I have literally 2 superiority dice left. That's it. And I've been saving them for this fight, and I've been blind for half of it.
Don't you have, like, superior vision or something? You can spend a die to get advantage on a hit or something?
No, I'm kind of... Well, I can only do, like, certain things with it.
You picked the wrong one, then.
You.
I took the one where I could block shit and run through shit. I haven't needed to use it quite yet, though.
Yeah,
I remember our fighter saved my ass using that.
Yeah. The riposte is really great because you can just straight up block shit.
He used his movement, picked me up in the middle of the movement, and continued running me back to Gerbender so he could heal me from dead.
He grits his teeth and he grabs hold of his board. He slams it on the staircase in front of him a couple of times. All right. Cognar.
Yes. Okay. Cognar's doing the thing again.
All right. Fire away.
Oh. 21.
He is down on the ground.
Yeah, boy. Doing the slashes.
Slash.
All right. So that is a 22.
That's going to hit.
And 22 to hit.
I think that's also going to hit.
Alright, so 2d8 plus 6. Nice. 12, 17.
17, nice. As you stab your blade into the man you just knocked down on the ground, you draw it back, and a spurt of blood kind of sprays up about the bookcase nearest him. And you stab down once again, deeply this time. You can feel the crunch of bones as you make impact with the wood behind you before drawing your blade again, leaving a deep red gash about please, his person.
Please tell me there's no blood magic on the shelf. That's it.
All right.
My turn's short and easy. I go up, I hit a guy, I'm done. Oh, if I was raging, ooh, another 4 damage on that.
Just a win. Is that a strength save every turn?
I was just looking for that.
Back and then it's
each creature that starts its turn in the line must succeed on a strength saving throw, be pushed 15 feet.
All right. And the DC is what?
14.
14. So the dwarf begins ascending the staircase one step at a time.
It's difficult terrain
his
to move.
Eyes
through, right?
Seem
it's yep. Double movement, okay. Yeah.
And his eyes are locked with Mushi, with a burning passion in his eyes. He looks towards her, raises his weapon with both hands. And Mushi, what is your AC? As this hammer is it right in the red circle? His hammer comes crashing down into the wood nearest you.
Oh shit!
They make impact before raising back and slamming against you. As you take the force of this impact, slamming you between his four hammer and the wall. There's a slight crunch in your grip as this happens.
Cognar hears that on the other side of the wall and goes, ooh!
You're going to take 11 points of bludgeoning damage.
It could have been worse.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm on the other side dealing with the boss.
3 points of fire damage, half to 1.
I think he's the boss.
And he's the asshole that made all this start. So.
And that continues glaring at you as he responds to you. If I am not, my brothers will be.
Ooh.
As the small little individual little nubs comes running after the defender.
They're playing patty cake.
I'm running down this way, and he swings at the defender with his little nub. And this guy is not going to break that 27 no matter what he tries to do as he continues pounding his little
It's only 25.
Oh, well, he's not going to break that either.
He would have to get 2 natural 20s.
As he's just pounding his nubs into the base of Bender's armor, completely unsuccessful. He takes a moment of looking up at Bender and begins coughing and choking as he does so.
Uh-oh.
A cloud of black, ashy smoke rises from his stomach, emanating out from his mouth. He continues coughing. The smoke cloud grows around him. That is a dexterity save
from you. Oh.
Been there, brother. Been there.
And you got disadvantage because of your armor?
Yes.
Oh.
Well, that was a check. Sorry.
Oh.
Right. So Gravender takes a moment to recoil, lifting his heavily armored arms up towards his face. But there is plenty of room gaps for the smoke to seep through and find purchase upon his eyes, as the vendor has just become effectively blind.
Oh, God.
And the cackling creature continues chanting language you do not understand. Ah, coffee. Ah, yeah. As Agnar.
Yeah. is.
The man in front of you takes a moment with his flaming scimitar in hand,
mm-hmm.
raises his arm up toward you,
mm-hmm.
and fires off a cacophonous wave of energy about you. Can I get a constitution save?
Oh, God.
As those on the other side of this bookcase hear the sound as a cannon just erupted on the other side of this bookshelf.
Ha ha ha. That was a 26 treat you.
Cognar takes a moment to deftly whip his shield up, taking the taking the blunt of this impact as he looks ever so cocky up above the crest of his shield towards the mage once again. And he says, "How does that treat you?" Before the mage seems to have a slight grin upon his face.
Uh-oh.
He says, "My friend, you were not the target. As I said, you will not see the light of day." Cognar takes a moment to realize the ladder behind him is completely shattered.
Oh, that's fine.
And with that, Katrina, as he places the hand, his other hand, against his chest and heals some of his wounds ever so slightly.
This guy's gonna do this all freaking day.
Remember, okay. He's a druid. Or at least pretended to be.
What an ass. I can pound on this guy all day. And he's like, ah.
Alright, so if I move, the dwarf gets an attack of opportunity against me, right?
If you move to the south.
Unless you attack him first.
Which I'm going to do. Because I'm next to my buddy, I'm going to get...
Sneak attack damage.
As long as you hit.
So that'll be...
Oh, what you did.
11 damage against him.
All right.
Nice.
As you break your blade across him.
And then...
You feel the fiery flames emanating from his own person. Erupting out onto your hand.
Oh, what the dickhead.
So you take 2 points of fire.
How many?
Two.
Okay. That's not too bad. Alright. And then, I'm on the ground, right?
No.
Okay.
But you're so on then... the floor, but not, like, laying down.
Okay, so I'm not prone.
Right.
Okay. So, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25... So that's 25. I can only see right here.
Right.
There's okay.
This kind of bookcase blocking your view.
Oh, okay. So I need to keep moving. Okay. So that's 30. Am I standing right next to Gurbender? Why can't I see him?
Because you're in darkness.
That's because Gurbender is currently blinded, so I had to put a little box around him.
Oh yeah, like I can't see like anything in this room. Like I can't see where Cognar is. I can't see the boss.
It's because I'm
Cognar and the boss are somewhere like over here.
Yes.
Yeah. Cognar is nowhere in sight. Rebender's in that little square down to your south, and this cloud of smoky dirt ash remains in your room.
Okay, so Gurbender's right there. So if I wanted. If I wanted to be flanking, I'd be right there.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I will flank with this thing.
You get advantage as well.
That was 20 feet of movement, 25. Okay.
That was the 30-minute alarm.
Okay. All right. So that's going to be 22 and 26.
And for damage, that's
11 and 7.
As you rake your blade across the back of this creature, it once again erupts a plume of smoke.
All right, and then knowing what happens after you killed them, I'm just going to keep moving.
Do you actually have that much more movement?
Go ahead and roll me an acrobatics check.
Yeah.
Acrobatics check. You're good at those, right?
I can do athletics.
You're not acrobatic?
Or acrobatics.
Or acrobatics? Okay. No, I'm not acrobatic. Not today. All right,
so Katrina begins making her way in the trail she kind of mapped out in her mind before her shin makes contact with something hard that sends her falling to the ground, effectively prone. With an impact upon her. That was just nice. Slightly picking out awesome. A little bit of a bad thought.
Darkness, man. This shit's a bitch.
You, the best thing is, Cognar has no idea what's going on the other side of this bookcase.
And they have no idea what's going on over there.
No, they don't.
All right, Katrina, anything else you would like to do?
I could spend the rest of my movement standing up, I guess.
I would.
All right. And from there, Drago. This fiery dwarf that you sent flying down the staircase is back up the top.
Okay, Drago's going to step there.
Eye contact with Mucius. They continue exchanging quips and remarks in this language you do not understand.
Oh, awesome. since the gust of wind is a concentration and it sticks with me, I want to aim it kind of like that.
Okay.
To try to blow all the smoke out of there and get him forced backwards.
So like that?
More angled so it catches all the smoke.
Oh, for the sake. Alright, so real quick, can I get a strength save from Verbender?
Well, he's already up against the wall, so he doesn't really need to move, does he?
But he could be knocked prone.
I thought it was just... I guess it is knocked... Yeah, okay. Strength save. Strength save.
Oh. I see Katrina.
Oh, I can see everything now.
It's awesome, isn't it?
About goddamn time. Well, look, there's a whole room here.
And there's no bad shit over here. Like, it's great.
So, Grabender, you have no idea what's going on, but you feel this force of wind slam you back against the wall, knocking you off of your feet. Having no sight, you have no idea what just caused this.
And it doesn't, like, clear my eyes of all the grit and dirt?
It does not.
It drives it further. You're even more blind.
Okay. Well, since all that, that's just me maintaining concentration. Or that's Drago maintaining concentration. I'm going to attack that guy.
Alright, real quick. He does go flying back, so Mushi and Drago get an attack of opportunity against him.
Well, I don't...
But...
I was going to say...
He gets the attack of opportunity because he leaves that area. But he doesn't get the bonus attack.
So it's the same thing.
Drago rakes with his scimitar. Mushi stabs with her staff or dagger. I got them both now.
Dagger, you have a better chance of hitting.
Mushi swings with her quarterstaff. As Drago swings with his scimitar, Mushi makes contact on the bronze body of him, and a fiery heat can be felt as Mushi takes 4 points of fire damage on making impact with her quarterstaff. That's half. As she deals 4 points. And Drago slashes with his scimitar, but does not make contact with the dwarf as he seems to be kind of whipped away before he can make purchase with his blade. Anything else Drago would like to do?
No, I think that's probably it.
All right, Grabender. You are currently laying on the ground, unable to see anything.
guess I'm going to try to regain my vision. Like, you know, wipe my eyes, that kind of stuff.
All right, go ahead and roll me a constitution save. Check.
Natural 20.
Right. Rebetta takes a moment to kind of move one gauntlet from a hand so he can reach his eyes. He manages to pull whatever kind of smoky, ashy grime was about his face.
Nice.
He's still laying on the ground, looking up at Katrina, immediately next to the body of his nubby friend.
Nubby.
That's my next goblin name, Nubby.
Okay. Well, before I get up, Bender is going to Sacred Flame the Dwarf.
Right.
Save. Wasn't it Cassie that did a wall of air that knocked me into that specter that almost killed me?
Probably.
Bender, as you fire off this bolt of Sacred Flame, how do you want it to be?
You killed the flaming dwarf guy?
I want, like, the dwarf to look shocked that something that looks like flame hurts. To have him, like, fire, crumple.
Fires across through the gust of wind that forced even this heavy metal dwarf backwards. He takes a moment hearing the sound from his peripheral to turn as this blazing radiant bolt slams deep into his chest. You can see for a split second, a moment of confusion as for the first time in his existence, he feels the pain of burning before he drops to his knees. Continues to slowly scoot forward, leaving this gust of wind.
Excellent. I want to, I guess, stand up and move there.
Right. As you make your way around, you can see the individual who is seated at the chair, puffing on his pipe, seems to be in melee combat with Cognar. As kind of strewn all about the room are splinters of wood in kind of varying degrees of size, as well as a hole up above Cognar that seems
to be a lead.
Basically, yeah. It's a...
How injured does Cognar look? Does he seem to be handling himself all right?
He seems to be handling himself fairly well.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Then I think that's probably all the movement I have. And since Drago now sees that like they're all dead, he'll go ahead and drop his gust of wind before the next turn starts.
All right. Yushi. All right. That's what you can see now.
Okay, I'll take everything.
Excuse me. Oh, if only I was a spellcaster right now.
All right. Cognar.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Cognar. All right. Same thing.
What did she just shoot a ray of frost at?
She's basically readying her action that if she sees an enemy, she fires the spell.
Ah. 22 for a strength check.
Yes. Oh.
All right.
He is effectively knocked off his feet at the force of this impact from the shield.
Well, that's not too bad. That's
as he lands on the ground, his arm kind of slams against the wood. As he does so, it kind of slips around the grasp of the hilt of the flaming scimitar he had. In a splash, the scimitar disappears.
Oh. Okay. 19 to hit.
That's gonna hit.
Okay. We'll do the second one. And another 19.
That's gonna hit.
2d8 plus 6. Oh, wow. That's the worst damage I've done this whole time. 10.
Thunder.
Yes.
How do you want to do this?
Yes!
You know, just a furious rage and hitting him with the shield and just... I almost don't even want to take the sharp part of the sword. I just want to bash him with the pommel until he dies.
All right. Cognar, as Grubender finally makes his way around this corner, he can see Cognar just beating this guy into a bloody pulp with a sword of all weapons. It is a gruesome sight to see.
Nope.
But with that, we are effectively out of...
Holy shit.
The party now finds themselves...
All right, I want to check this guy for stuff.
All right.
Does anybody want to check the room for valuables? This guy's a wizard.
That's essentially what Bucci just said she wants to do.
Oh, well.
Katrina, being the greedy bitch that she is definitely going to help.
Yes.
I'm going to point out that I saw the bookshelf lined with all kinds of druidy books to Draco.
And as Draco hears this from Grubender, he takes a moment to indicate that he can see flames rising from the staircase. As the tower continues to burn below you.
I'm just doing a quick glance at him, and then once I'm done with that, I have something I want to do.
Okay. So, Lucas, that was for your investigation check?
Correct.
Grubender's going to tell everybody, you know, hurry, the tower is burning, we need to hurry.
Hurry,
and then try to help find anything that might be useful.
All right, I'm checking the desk.
This is not the top. There seems to be a pile of wood near Cognar, as well as a gap in the ceiling above, and the kind of top couple of rungs of what was once a lot.
Apparently, Grubender is still blind.
Do I find anything in the desk?
One second. As Katrina goes for the desk.
I will take that.
How do you care about the desk?
All right. So Mishi, come up so you can kind of role play. So this is the area you see. Grubender shouted out to Drago that he saw some. Ben, would you remind me what you shouted out to Drago across the room? As far as what you saw? No.
Yeah, say that again, Zin. Sorry, I missed it.
What did you yell out to Drago across the room?
Basically that, like, the bookshelf had lots of druidy books.
All right, so that's what Grubender said.
Want to look at that desk
since we filled the desk. Katrina's currently at the desk. This desk, kind of more desk with kind of, and this is another desk with kind of papers strewn about. More of these books that Grubender saw earlier.
I just kind of want to see, like, what it just them are saying, like if they have specific spells they're pointing out, talking about the ritual
leading
informant.
So looking about the
desk. Cognar, do you have a bag of holding?
I do.
Yes.
Then we just need to grab every book and paper we can and shove it in there.
Perfect.
Okay. I'll hold the bag open. You sweep the shelf.
lunar cycles and all that kind of various books on different druidic.
You looted his body, right?
Yeah. Totally druidic.
Grab everything.
Okay, do we loot the dwarf's body?
No.
Okay, I'm going to loot the dwarf's body.
Okay, and then I'm going to point out the ladder, I guess, and say we need to
get it. Say it so they can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
I'm going to point out the pile of woods Bogdar is standing next to and say we probably need to keep moving up if we plan on living.
Okay.
Grab everything you can and let's go.
Yep.
Is that a chest there?
That looks like a chest.
I just said, can we open the chest?
Can we put the chest in the bag of holding? I've done that before. And a djinn tried to take it away.
You really better
opening of a bag.
Okay.
So you really better hope that it's not an extra-dimensional storage place.
I'm going to pop open the chest then.
All right, Katrina, there seems to be a small padlock upon this chest. If you would like to attempt to roll me a thief's tools check.
All right, so that's 18, and then add 5 to that for my gloves. Oh, and I'm want to make sure I check it for traps too, because I have trap.
You already picked the lock.
So Katrina, after a split second working with your tools, the padlock pops open, and the chest now lies before you unlocked.
Okay, I loot.
All right. So as you whip open this chest, there seems to be nothing inside of it.
Okay, I'm going to do a perception check and check for, like, false bottoms, switches, anything in the top.
All right, go ahead and roll me an investigation check.
Oh, good, not perception. Better!
All right, so Katrina, you begin kind of just tapping and thumping upon the various walls of this small little chest. But you're not finding anything. Where did you want
to be? I'm going over to the ladder trying to see if I can, rope up or...
I've got rope.
Yeah. All right. So, see if I can lasso onto one of those things and,
Oh, that's just what I was writing.
So
we'll do it together, so one of us takes advantage.
I'm going to go over there and, how high is it to the ceiling?
It is... ...40 feet up to the ceiling.
What?
As Yushi makes a small loop in her rope before tossing it up, makes it maybe halfway up before falling back down to the ground.
Okay.
Guys, there's a rug. Should we jump out the window?
Hang on a second.
No. Let's not do that.
How tall are these bookshelves?
Drago totally has this.
Oh, wait. Drago has it? Tell me he's got the mending spell.
Katrina's going to yell out, "Hurry up! Here comes the fire!" As she runs over.
Drago's going to take the rope and just go straight up the wall and over the ceiling to wherever the hole to get out is.
Does she want
to...
All right.
Does he want to put that on someone that can pull everybody up?
He's got to get up there first.
Yeah, but he can cast it on me and I can pull everybody up.
As Drago casts the spell on himself and is already ascending this wall, Cognar's like, "Hey, you want to cast that on me?" And he receives no response. From their newest companion. As Drago ascends the tower, making it up there, he finds himself upon a floor nearly completely coated with the smoke that continues to rise from down below. But he has made it up successfully.
Tie that shit off.
Yeah, he's going to find somewhere to tie the rope off and drop it down. And given that he has a dark vision of 60 feet, is it the smoke that means he can't see further than this?
I would say his vision is lightly obscured in this with his dark vision.
I just want to make it to level 6.
And what he sees as he's kind of being tied off the top of this rope, something swoops through the smoke.
Of course.
And what is his AC?
His AC is 14.
So he can feel three rapid attacks into his person, one after another, as these large wings swoop about him as he takes very high up.
Oh my god. This is, if I was raging, I'd just run down the fucking tower, but
he takes 15 points of piercing damage.
15?
15. But he does manage to tie this rope off.
Cognar's climbing. So I'm
going to ask everybody to roll me initiative.
Oh. Of course, now I start rolling 11 for Cognar. Cognar is not going up the rope first, apparently. I'm sure one of those... Oh, never mind.
Is it 15?
15 for Cognar, yes. No, sorry. 11 for Cognar.
So Grabender can still see Drago, right?
Yeah. At the very... Roll me a perception check. Because this is almost on the verge of the firelight provided by the torches. Bender, you see large leathery wings wrapping around Drago in rapid succession before he kind of cries out as a small spatter of blood falls down by the party as this happens.
Okay.
Well, is there anything I can do?
Plus two.
Oh my god, I just thought of something incredibly stupid.
Alright. With that, there's another swoop upstairs.
I want to get up the ladder of the thing. Does he have mending? Can you just cast mending on the stupid ladder?
I thought about that.
In place, he could, but because the ladder's effectively been blown up.
Yeah, there were just going to be way too many...
too many pieces to mend. I really
this time, Drago feels the impact of razor-sharp claws raking across his person for only 6 piercing damage this time.
He's going to die by the time we get up there.
And with that, Defender is up.
Okay.
Anything for climbing speed.
First thing Grabender is going to do. He is going to climb the rope.
All right. Go ahead and roll me an acrobatics or athletics check with advantage. Without advantage, just a straight number because of your armor. Straight number, 18. You begin climbing up this rope. You can feel a heavy tension on the rope as you do so. As it begins to slowly give ever so slightly, like a couple of inches in slack.
Oh, no.
Just simply from the weight of your armor. But you do begin climbing up. And you make it about halfway up this rope as you do so.
Okay. Then I guess I'm just going to double move.
All right. Go ahead and roll me one more athletics check.
No way,
Grabender continues pulling himself up before he feels a sharp pain like a cramp in his arm as his ascent slows. Roll me one more athletics check to see if you hold on to the rope or not. And Grabender's grip slips as he falls down 20 feet. Maintaining a total of 10 feet up the ladder.
Oh my god.
Oh god, why don't we die? die.
We are gonna die.
Is
there anything you would like to do as a bonus action?
Yeah. As a bonus action, I'm gonna cast a level 2 healing word. I can get there. So that's for Drago.
All right. Drago heals 11 hit points. For the sake of making everyone's lives a little bit easier for this point in time, we can move over here to the map. If everyone can see there.
Yeah. That's nice.
I see Drago up there.
There's a ladder.
Then keeps swooping. And the ladder is representing your guys' rope.
This is intense.
Well, that's all the points. That's all that Grabender's got. All
right. Yushi. And real quick, I'll throw on a bookshelf. It's 20 feet up. Bookshelf.
Yay,
bookshelf.
Bookshelf. It just crushed Mushi.
Yeah, he did, you know. I guess I'm gonna try and climb the rope. I'm not strong enough to push a freaking bookshelf. Yeah, I'm gonna climb the rope.
Go ahead and roll me 2d.
Nine,
16 plus 2, you begin climbing up. Make your way to Grabender. Would you like to attempt to climb around him?
Yeah.
All right. Only one more.
I'll totally help her. I'll like.
10 plus 2. She manages to climb over Grabender up this ladder about halfway.
And I'm trying to stop.
All right. 2 more details.
Oh. Good.
12 and 1. Mushi continues her ascent up. Drago grasps her hand as she reaches the top. And stand by. Effectively, this is what you can see.
I don't.
There is a light here. They pit. Oh, right there. That you just climbed up.
That's the hole we just climbed
up. That's the hole you just climbed up.
I mean, bonus action too.
Do you?
Like, I can't use that wind.
No bonus action spells. All right. All right, Cognar.
Cognar's going up the rope.
All right. 2d20. Natural 20. That'll do. You make your way up the rope and you get to Grabender. Would you like to attempt to climb over?
Yes.
Go ahead and roll me another d20.
Okay.
Plus athletics, right?
What's the d20?
Three,
yes, plus athletics.
Nine.
The Cognar begins attempting to climb up Grabender, and this weight is a little bit too much for Grabender with his ramp.
Oh,
God. Both of them descend down the rope, the remaining 10 feet, back down to the ground.
All right, I use my dash action to climb again.
All right, go ahead and roll me 2d20s.
18.
Cognar makes his way halfway up the rope.
Is it half movement?
Yeah. And with that, there's another swoop from upstairs. And what is Drago's AC?
14.
It's like a circus show in here.
Drago razor sharp claws rake against him once again, and Mushi can see that looks like that before it tears its razor sharp claws into you.
I'm going to yell down to the group. Big bat. Watch out.
As both Mushi and Drago take 4 points of slashing damage. 21.
Oh my god.
What's he at?
He's at like half health.
Oh, that's not too bad.
I just want to get up this rope. I don't like being on ropes. That's bad.
All right, Katrina.
Oh, no.
Okay, so it's athletics to climb?
Yeah, athletics or acrobatics.
Yeah.
With advantage. Because you guys are using a rope.
Okay, so 22, and I could dash, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, you can. But a 22 gets you up to Cognar. Would you like to attempt to climb past him?
Yeah.
Go ahead and roll me another athletics check. Just 1d20 this time.
22.
Basically jump, passing over Cognar as you do so. And with that, go ahead and roll me another athletics check with advantage.
You weren't so nimble earlier when you ran into the suitcase.
24. I was blind.
You continue your ascent of this rope. That is...
Ah, everything's dark.
All right, 1 second. Grab the wrong token. And you come up to Mushi's legs, who are currently in the process of being pulled up. And this is what you see, this smoky room with almost completely coated in darkness, save for a single point of light that seems to be coming down from up above with a ladder down below it, illuminating this ladder. But the smoke that seems to have been rising up from the tower this whole time seems to have mostly gathered in this room, in this space, before slowly filtering out the small hole you can see.
Okay. How much of my movement do I have left? 20?
If you used your dash...
You said it was a 40-foot rope?
Yeah, so you can
get so I have 20?
You can get to the top.
Oh, no, I'd have 40 more. Wow.
No, it's half movement
to climb.
You use your full movement.
It doesn't just count as difficult terrain?
Oh, he's got the mobile feet.
Not really difficult terrain for the sake of feet, no.
Okay, that's fair. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so is there... So can I see anything?
Roll me a perception check.
Now, if you had a wonderful potion, you could just...
9. No, I can't. No.
You cannot see anything through this smoky haze.
Alright. Well, then I'll just kind of pull myself up into the room.
Alright. Katrina, as you begin pulling yourself up the final stretch of this rope, what is your AC?
It is 15.
As you feel the swoop of large leathery wings diving down on you, the rake of claws across your back as you're kind of pulling yourself up before disappearing from sight again deals 3 points of piercing damage to you. As you turn around rapidly in order to see what just did this, there is nothing but the smoke kind of swirling about as if it had just been disturbed. With that, Drago is up once again. Or for the first time since initiative, but he is.
Okay.
What?
He's going to continue on up the wall.
All right.
Without the ropes tied off. And so, try to get a better view on some shit.
Back over here, if he wants to continue up the wall, feel free to move his token. Currently, the hole in the wall is over there on the other side of the room. But if he just wants to kind of climb up the wall, this is the token.
The ceiling.
All right, go ahead and roll me another perception check. This time with advantage.
Come on, Drago.
Nice.
Natural 20.
Beautiful. He sees all the things.
All of the things. And the things he sees are very friendly.
Not
looking. As he climbs his way up into the rafters, effectively this is what he sees, kind of scattered about the room in various positions.
Do you think we have 10 minutes?
Are any of them within striking range?
He can certainly try to reach out at one as it circles round.
Okay. Well, he's going to, instead of attempting to reach out for one, he's going to do that.
Oh.
All right. So he fires off this flame he has just produced, and it makes impact on the creature nearest him that seems to be flapping around the room, now focused on Drago, as this fire erupts up above Katrina and Mushi. For a split second, they see large leathery wings kind of silhouetted in the smoke before disappearing, as the creature seems to take 9 points of fire damage. Anything else Drago would like to do at this point in time?
Nope. That's pretty much all he's got.
All right. As the creature lunges towards Drago, claws outstretched, raking ever effectively against the wall beside Drago, splintering the wood, leaving behind a large claw mark as it does so before flying off. And with that, Gerbender is up.
Shall the circus act?
Gerbender's going. I was just going to hold, wait for Cognar to get up the rope.
All right.
Actually hold, like, my whole turn.
Right.
Okay.
All right, Mushi. You just got pulled up by Drago. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Do I see
any? Do a perception check.
Okay, I'm going to back the corner.
All right.
And next.
Alright. Okay. Cognar.
Yeah, Cognar's climbing.
Alright, go ahead and roll me that athletics or acrobatics.
That is a 14.
14. Cognar continues his ascent of this rope and manages to get pulled up the final couple of feet by Katrina, who's up top.
Ooh, and I see the bats.
Roll me a perception check.
We will tell you there are bats.
Right, perception. That's 9.
You do not.
Okay. Well, I've been hearing people getting
swirling about. Right? But nothing inside of the smoke, save for your companions.
Okay, I'm going to ready an action.
All right.
When, if something comes and attacks me. Or anywhere right. Close within me, I guess. Within range.
And once again, there's a swoop about the room. Mm-hmm. The smoke is once again disturbed. And both Drago and Mushi. Drago feels the rake of claws against him once again, taking 8 points of piercing damage. And Mushi feel her robes being ripped and torn as she fires off a bolt of fire that simply fizzes out at the palm of her hand, rolling a natural one.
Does that trigger my held action?
Cognar, roll me one more perception check.
Even worse.
It does not.
Am I still holding that action then?
I would, yes.
Okay.
So that if you are attacked, I will give you another opportunity. Okay. Katrina, you are currently up.
Okay. Can I see anything around me?
Roll me a perception check.
That is no. Okay.
No,
wow, we can't see shit.
And it's because of smoke, right? Not because of lack of light?
It's both for you. You don't have the light to see at a distance as well as the smoke cloaking whatever might be up here.
Okay. And can I... Like, is breathing becoming a problem at all?
Not so much here at the ground floor, but Drago's starting to get maybe a little lightheaded. It's not necessarily affecting him, but as you go up, the smoke is thicker the higher you go.
Yes. I forgot about something I had. Wind fan.
Oh, you have the wind fan.
I have the wind fan. Where is that damn item link, though?
You just cast gust of wind.
Okay, so I'm going to try to blow the smoke away using the wind fan.
Like towards the ladder thing?
Like towards the light that I can see, yeah.
Towards the hole in the roof you can see?
Yeah.
All right.
Do I have to do anything to do it?
I'm checking that now. No, you don't.
The first time you don't. Try to use it again before the day's over. You'll have to make a roll.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Or else it'll break and tear. Okay. So, yeah, Katrina's just going to pull this fan out of her pack, and she's going to open it up, and then she's just going to whoosh, whoosh, whoosh.
All right.
Yay.
Okie doke. So the smoke begins forcefully billowing out of this room, and effectively at the start of your next turn, as long as you maintain concentration on this, which I'm not positive if you have to do or not because it's an item, but effectively at the end of your next turn, the smoke will have successfully been forced out through this opening. But it is slowly starting to clear the room.
Cool.
I was
really and with that, Cognar, there is a swoop nearby you.
Yes.
And you can go ahead and roll me an attack with disadvantage.
Okay, well, I was actually going to grapple. I'm trying to grab onto it.
Hey, question. Is that thing flying through the gust of wind?
No, it's going around it, of course.
Not this one. No.
Can I try to grab whatever's that's swooping at me?
You can certainly try.
Okay. Athletics, I think, right? For a grapple? Or that's a straight strength, I think. Never mind. Natural one. Fuck you, die.
Nope. All right. So Cognar reaches for whatever just swooped by, but he is a little too slow. Being slightly distracted by the gust of wind that has just forced its column of air through the room.
Hmm. Okay. Well, it attacks me, right?
It doesn't me. Okay. But it does rake across your shield with a large screeching sound as if nails across the top.
Nice.
Drago.
Okay. Drago is going to make his way over towards the light, assuming that I can kind of move that way across the walls.
Yeah. It is a kind of pyramid-like roof shape.
And
if I'm like trying to kind of avoid the wind, can I do that and still get there?
So
like, I want to be close to it.
It is really weird doing this three-dimensionally. So using his 30 feet of movement, he can make it across the wall to this corner where he can begin making his way effectively south towards the opening.
All right, well then he'll do that.
More than the 30 feet. Otherwise, 30 feet gets him to this corner.
And I assume I can still see the things?
Yeah.
And if I can tell which one I hit before, I want to hit it again.
All right. Fire away. This time...
be really distracted. And
this time you fire off the creature that you can see the moment you see it. And as the flame leaves your hand, you remember about that gust of wind that is now torrenting through the room. As the fire goes to make its way through the column of air, it is just extinguished in an instant.
That figures.
Anything else you would like to do?
Let's see. No.
All right.
Okay, so where Grabender had held his turn from before.
Yes, he did.
I rolled athletic. Oh.
All right. Things. Stop. But go ahead with that health turn. Okay, you rolled athletics. You got an 18.
Well, so I rolled a 5 first, so that means I didn't really make it anywhere.
See? But you don't go anywhere. Before, you kind of need the cramp out of your arm. I'm assuming the second is to take the dash.
Right.
Going up the rope. And with that, you kind of... hearing the cries of those up above you, you rally yourself and force through the pain of your shoulder to climb up this rope upstairs.
All right. I'm going to continue trying to climb.
All right. Athletics check.
Come on, check. There it is.
Now, when Bender makes it up.
Finally.
Render okay. The rope.
Now that I'm finally up here.
Roll me a perception check.
Okay.
All right, so Grabender makes his way up, but he doesn't see the creatures that are attacking the party.
But can I see everybody in the party?
You can see Mushi, Cognar, and Katrina. But you do... Actually, you can see Mushi and Cognar. You cannot see Katrina nor Drago in this room.
Okay. In that case, I am using the glow globe. And...
Alright.
Gonna use it to cast light.
Alright.
Actually, screw that. I'm gonna use it to cast daylight.
Alright.
Oh.
It gets a little brighter in here. As Grabender pulls from his pocket this really solid golden orb, he speaks its command word before releasing it, and it hovers in the air for a moment before it, as if the sun itself were in the room with you guys. It erupts into this bright daylight, the likes of which you guys have not seen. And
it has been rather dark today.
That, in addition to the light of the sun itself, was dimmed due to the eclipse.
That's what I'm saying. It's been rather dark today.
But currently, Grabender's daylight is brighter than daylight itself.
Okay. Now I can see everybody.
Now you can see everybody.
Good.
You were seeing a little pressure.
So I'm assuming that was a bonus action to make that happen?
Yes.
Excellent. So that's my movement. That's my bonus action. And now I am casting Spirit Guardians.
Nice.
We're fighting this in the middle of a tower that's going down in flames?
Yep. Where have you been?
No, I'm just...
the last three levels.
Cognar's the dumb one, and he wants to get the hell out of the burning tower.
No, no. You don't understand. Spirit Guardians is a 15-foot sphere around me that if anything comes into it, it has to make a wisdom save or take damage.
That's true.
And I'm excluding Mushi, Cognar, Katrina, and Drago.
Of course.
Are you sure? You don't have to.
I know I don't have to, but I'm going to.
I mean, okay. That's what you want to do. All right.
Ooh, I like the effects of the Spirit Guardian behind the daylight. That's awesome.
Let's see. All right.
Anything
else you would like to do?
I think that's enough for now.
All right, Mushi. Yep. And I'll roll you a perception check.
Does anybody else see that floor?
Yeah, it's all crackly.
Yeah.
Floor doesn't seem to be of the most solid material.
Oh, shit.
Guy
the whole tower wasn't of the most solid material.
Except for I couldn't break that one floor. Four people standing on it.
That's going to hit as Mushi fires off a spell up into the rafters. It slams into something up above, freezing it ever so slightly.
10 damage, nice.
And as she does so.
There. Yeah. All right.
That's my turn.
All right, Cognar.
Okay.
Cognar.
Oh, Cognar has seen this maneuver once before. He's going to use it to his advantage this time again. Okay, so here's what I want to do. I want to move to the other side of Katrina, jump in her gust of wind to get a boost of 15 feet. Can I do that?
You can certainly try.
Yes, I can. Okay. All right, so it's there, and does that put me in there? The corner of it, I guess?
I would say it'd have to be there.
Okay, well, then that's 5'10".
Actually, I've got a better graphic I can use that has the squares.
Ooh.
Not so much for gust of wind, but...
For something other evil that you want to hit us with?
Ah, essentially, like that,
but double the size. So it's
right.
10 feet wide.
Yeah.
Right. And that
is really cool.
Very nice fire breath.
Like that.
Okay. So yeah. Okay. So that's 5.
Flame.
10 feet of movement to get into the flaming wind wall.
Okay.
And I'm willingly going with the wind. So do I have to make the strength save if I'm willingly going with it?
I would say it could happen naturally as you're forced 10 feet forward.
Is it 10 or 15?
I think it's 10.
For sure it's 15.
Gust of wind. 15 feet.
Yep, forward. Okay. All right, so that was 10 feet.
Go ahead and roll me a acrobatics check.
To stay up?
Yes.
13.
All right. What's its DPC? Beats it, beats it. All right.
Sweet. All right, so that was only 10 feet of my movement. 15... 20, and I'm going up the ladder.
All right. So Cognar begins climbing the ladder.
How big is the ladder?
It's 5, 10, 15, 20 feet.
All right, so I've got 15 feet of movement, so I get up.
Feet left?
Yeah, I got 15 feet once I hit the
ladder. 10 feet of the ladder, so halfway up the ladder.
Okay, cool.
All right.
And I will double move out of the hole.
All right. Cognar continues climbing up, and I'm going to need you to roll me a strength save. And you find yourself in this pillar of air.
Oh my god. 16.
16. So you can feel it forcing against your back as you are essentially thrown across the way.
Oh shit.
Onto this small landing up top. Okay. And
okay.
And this ladder seems to lead up to a small platform that was built, looks to be for repairs to the roof. About you look to be supplies, kind of various shingles, rope, as well as what looks to be a climbing kit.
Okay. I will grab the climbing kit and the rope and start fastening it on.
All right. Effectively using the rest of your turn to do that.
Correct, yeah.
All right. So two large creatures swoop through the room once again. I don't believe it says anything about flying creatures, so like essentially if they pass their strength save, they're all right in the gust of wind, right?
Yeah, I don't think it says anything specifically.
I would guess so, yeah.
Okay. So two creatures swoop about the room, targeting Katrina. As they do so, Katrina, what is your AC?
15.
They both need to make DC 13 wisdom saving throws.
Yeah, they've got a 19 and a 16.
They take 9 damage each.
Nice.
That is right. Sorry, that was not the wisdom saves. I think that was the strength save. That. So a 17 and a 2. So one takes, what is it, 18 radiant?
Yep, and one takes 9.
All right.
Nice.
So one comes swooping towards Katrina, making it just inside of Grabender's spiritual guardians, and all of a sudden a number of spirits swarm around it with blades in hand, and their holy light rips through this creature. It falls down to the ground, plummeting as it does so into the wooden floor that collapses beneath the weight of this creature.
Had to avoid
saw that,
that
coming.
Putting a hole into the floor as it disappears from sight as more smoke plumes up from down below. You guys can see this creature disappearing into the flames. But you get more light up here. Is this yet?
More light than daylight?
More, I guess because daylight, it doesn't really make a difference.
The smoke should be clear by now, right?
What?
You said the smoke would be clear at the beginning of Katrina's turn?
At the beginning of Katrina's turn, yes. But currently there is a second bat who just took the 9 damage, who did successfully attack Katrina for a whopping 3 piercing damage.
Ooh. DC 10.
Ouch.
Are you rolling that he needs concentration on that or not?
It's a fan. Do I have to maintain concentration?
I would say no for this item. And with that, the smoke dissipates about the room. Katrina, you can see a number of creatures kind of swarming about up top that you didn't immediately notice the first time through. You are dead. I need an X on you. It's swarming all about the room. Up top in the rafters. that seem to fly down, take a swipe, and then fly back up. As well as the floor around you seems to be questionable at best. Seeing the floor collapse under the weight of the creature who just impacted it, you may want to tread carefully.
God, Gravender's got super armor on too.
So is this thing, this is the one that just hit the ground?
No, the one that just hit the ground fell through this hole.
Oh, okay.
Created this hole while falling through the ground.
Okay, and what's this fire ray here?
That's the wind, gust of wind spell that you cast.
Okay. So, is it an athletics to get over the floor?
So, it would be acrobatics to get across the floor, but to go through the gust of wind, it would be a strength save.
Even, well, can I do what Cognar did and just willingly?
Absolutely, but you might
willingly let it take me.
You might be not prone to doing so.
Prone through the floor? Oh my god.
And bad things could happen.
Well, I'm gonna try to get across the floor.
Willingly jumping into the gust of wind?
Yeah.
Alright.
Hey, it's just 15 feet a moment.
15 feet. And can you roll me a strength save?
Well, if I dash, can I go further?
Jumping into it immediately, I believe it takes effect.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, if I do my whole movement as a dash, can I move further?
If you want to run around it, you can. Like, if you wanted to run south.
So if I wanted to run around it, could I get more movement?
You can't go to the left because of the hole that's there, but you can go to the south to attempt to run around it before the diving, jumping.
You can make it in your standard movement.
The thing is, if you go the 15 feet, even if you fail your saving throw, that means you just go prone, and you'd have to spend half your movement to get up, so it basically is equal. More or less.
Mm-hmm.
If you succeed at your saving throw, then you get a free 15 feet of movement.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So let's do that then. I get you. Okay. All right. So what do I need to do? Acrobatics?
Yeah.
Are you going through the wind?
11.
All right. So as Katrina begins diving into this gust of wind, it's slightly stronger than what she expected it to be as she tumbles one roll further than she had anticipated, landing flat on her ass as she does so.
All right, and then I'm going to get up and keep moving up the ladder.
All right. You stand up and continue moving through the difficult terrain of this area, but taking a dash action with your feet negates the difficult terrain of this area. But you do begin climbing the ladder, and you do have enough movement to make it up the ladder. If you can roll me one more strength save as you make your way to the top of the ladder before feeling the gust of wind at your back once again.
No. Ugh.
Cognar, being up on top, kind of readying yourself with the various bips and bobs of ropes, mm-hmm. you see Katrina pulling herself up the top of the ladder before being whipped off the edge of the hall.
Can I try to grab her?
You are currently preoccupied. As there looks to be nothing between her and a roughly 100-foot drop down to the smoldering scaffolding that the party left down below.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
Is there any way I can throw the rope at her? And then attempt to hook something?
No.
I tried.
As you do. As the
swoop. Did she say the potion of flying?
Yep. Swooping towards Drago, being trapped in this little corner, it rakes across the wood on either side of him, unable to reach him and make purchase with its claws. But that Drago is up.
Okay. Drago is going to continue along the wall towards the ladder and everything.
All right.
So I guess like at 30, he can basically get right up next to the thing.
Yes, sir.
And like if he takes one more step, he's in the gust of wind, right?
Essentially, yes.
Okay.
Because currently he's kind of in the gust of wind, but the opening is 5 feet further.
Oh. He's just going to stand right where he is. And shoot another produce flame attack thingy.
All right.
At whichever of the bats looks
this
most injured.
Chest fur seems to be singed slightly.
Okay, but that's on the other side of the wind, so.
Drago can take an additional step to go up 5 feet, firing up above the gust of wind.
We'll do that then.
All right. As another bat drops down from the ceiling, landing, crashing down into the floor as it does so, creating another gap in the floor, almost immediately next to Fushi as it falls. Anything else Drago would like to do?
Maybe make a note of these things so he might be able to transform into them at some later date.
All right, nice.
Maybe.
You can add that into the notes.
What giant bat?
Add it to the inventory notes down at the bottom, the treasure loot inventory notes.
Mm-hmm.
Giant bat. Because this is indeed a beast.
Ron would be so proud.
He can't turn into anything that flies yet, but someday.
Someday.
Yeah. I wonder what his CR is at that level.
Is there anything else he would like to do at this point in time?
Nope.
All right, then with that, we are going to have to call it for the night.
Yeah.
I'm like dying over here.
Wait. We're calling it for the night while I'm falling off the side of the tower?
Yep.
You son of a bitch.
Gust of wind there. That has just forced Katrina off the side. And this is no longer here. It's a smoldering pile of ruins down at the bottom.
We are so screwed.
I'm so dead. I'm falling off the
Don't
side of
the
Don't
you have something for this? Like,
I've got rope. I could try.
Can't you try to, like, grab the platform or whatever?
Oh, I'm going to try anything I can.
That's what Rom said.
Oh, that is what Rom said when he dropped 200 feet and died.
It was a spider. He didn't know any
better. He didn't know any better. He didn't know he had a rage or a flying potion.
Don't worry. I'll loot your dead body and cut your head off and give it to your vendor.
Aww.
That is comforting.
Yep, that's a thing that happened.
Yes, it is.
As is tradition.
I didn't get it.
Okay, I gotta go, guys.
See you,
Ben. Alright. Thank you, Ben.
Thank you.
Later.
Bye.
Congratulations again, sir. Yeah. Way to
Thank
go.
You, sir.
Good job.
And real quick for the rest of you, if I can, get the character highlights for this session, as well as what they hope to accomplish next session.
All right, I'll go first. Highlight was two highlights. One, killing the suave flame guy. That was great. The second one was, again, using creative mechanics to get extra movement for my little feet. And next session is to get off this fucking tower.
All right. I think you guys are going to manage to get off this tower one way or another next time.
Somebody's going to. I might have to grab a hold
Alive
of Yushi and make her chug that potion. We're just going to jump off.
Bob Dar has no no idea.
All right.
I hear you talking about it. You talk about it all the time with Grabender. Oh, I've got a flying potion.
I knew she's saying that. And for Katrina, character highlight for this session, and what does she hope to accomplish next session?
Got some loot. Definitely the character highlight. What do I hope to not die from falling off the side of a goddamn building. and yeah, that's about it. I'm a little of... I can't believe I'm falling off a building right now. Yeah, I have to wait a week for that.
You know, I think you could have turned off your gust of wind before you did that.
It's the fan. It's an item. I can't turn it off.
I thought he has no control of turning it off. It's there forever?
Until
for 1 minute, right?
Yep.
Well...
And Mushi, character highlight for this session. What does Mushi hope to accomplish next session?
Honestly, Mushi loves talking with the dwarves. That was just awesome. Like, I didn't get the answer to myself before, but I was pretty ecstatic about that. yes, next session, I have to go down instead of figure my way down.
All right.
She's also an awesome ice mage, like.
Apparently so. Fire is not her element of choice. Apparently.
I'm sensing to go with ice, but I'm drawn to fire. I guess, guys, maybe after this I'll become an ice mage.
Well, guys, excellent session tonight. Yes. And if you didn't get my Skype message, if you can, whenever you get a moment, just copy down like your inventory and like your character stats and the like. Because on our Tuesday night session game, Roll20 changed the character sheets, and it essentially kind of deleted all the information on them.
I screenshotted everything.
Okay, it's kind of like a backup in case that happens here. I don't know what they're doing or if they're trying to get rid of these character sheets or what, but better safe than having no idea what anyone's got anymore. We've already lost all the characters in Midori once.
Yeah, I
would need
to, like, take a picture.
He says maliciously.
All right. So see you guys next Sunday, Will, or we find out what happens with Katrina, yeah, who's taking her first flight lesson.
Yay! Flight school. It's always been a dream of mine.
Well, I'm glad to make your dreams a reality.
Lothar knows all about flying to his doom.
Right, adios, guys. See you guys.
See ya.